don't you say, well, I think I'm going to work with a particular type of property or situation or person, you want to prove your value. Now, when we talk about that, you're going to have to do, it's not just enough to say, oh, this is what I work on. Well, you need to prove it. You need to go to some workshops on it. You need to go to conferences in it. You may want to get a designation in it. There are a number of designations that NAR, the Real Estate Council, and other organizations offer. So you want to prove your value so that when you're putting that this is your niche in your bio, that people believe you. They know it. You can prove it. You have some credibility in it. Okay. Number three, I want to make sure we're sticking with our time here. We're good. Number three, you want to specialize within your specialty. So even in a niche, for example, luxury, you may specialize in luxury condos, or you may specialize in gated communities. You may specialize in golf communities. There are so many different niches even within a niche. So once you find your niche, you may have to narrow it down even more. Number four, on your way to becoming that niche agent, that specialty, that specializing agent, you want to become the local expert. With that, what that means is you're micro famous for being the go-to person for what it is you specialize in. So people say, oh, golf community, you got to see this person here. Oh, high-rise condo, this person's the one. You want to become the local expert. Part of that is you need to promote what you do on a day-to-day basis. We have this statement that we use in your social media marketing and so forth. You attract what you promote. So if you're on social media and you're saying, I am the equestrian expert, I can help you find your horse farm. And that is who I'm going to be. You have horses as part of your logo. You have horses in your packet. All of that is horses. And then you say, well, here I am selling a townhome, you know, a $500,000 townhome. Just understand there's nothing wrong with doing that, but you're not showing your niche by doing that. So if you're going to specialize, you really want to specialize. It's not to say that you can't represent that $500,000 townhome. I'm not saying that because trust me, I have some luxury properties and I still represent whatever, you know, I can if it works and doesn't take me off my path. But what I am saying is I don't promote it as heavily because my niche is really the global luxury stuff. I hope I'm making sense. And you can type in the chat if that makes sense. I'll go back and look at it. But you want to have articles on your website about your niche. If there's an article that comes out in Forbes or the New York Times or Mansion Global, you want to post that on your website. Number five, I'm going to get through this because I understand it's slowing down a little bit. Number five, to thine own self be true. That is a quote from William Shakespeare. Where are my literists out, my literary experts? Polonius said, to thine own self be true. It was kind of a warning in Hamlet by Shakespeare. And the point was, to your own self be true, and then you won't be false with any man. That's what Polonius said in Hamlet. We need to be true to ourselves. If we say, for example, I'm going to be honest, I can't say I'm an equestrian expert. I don't go to horse farms. I don't go to horse races. I don't know a lot about horses. I think I went horseback riding one time and was scared to death the whole time. So it wouldn't be true for me to say that's my expertise. Okay, it may be a cool expertise. It may be one I aspire to do, but I need to learn a little bit more about it before I can claim it as a niche. So to your own self be true. Do you even enjoy golf? And you say you're a golf, gated community golf expert, a niche specialist? I would be careful about that. Do you even sponsor golf tournaments? To your own self be true. Who are you? That's what you want to answer that question. If your values are shallow, your victories will be empty. That's a statement I put in there because to me it relates to being true. And make sure when we're selecting our niches that we're not doing it because we think that's where the money flows. We need to be very careful about that because that's very shallow. And at the end, we may still feel very empty, even if we do score one or even if we do sell one, because deep down inside, we know that's not who we really are. Number six, we want to keep building those connections within our niche area, always promoting and connecting and networking with people in your area. Go to golf tournaments. If I'm just using golf as an example, you may not even care about golf, but if that's what you want to do, sponsor one. You want to keep building those connections of people who are in that. Go to golf stores. You know, share your business cards. See, you know, if you can promote anything there, if that's going to be your niche. Number seven, this is the last one. Know your local landscape. I wouldn't say, you know, I live in the DMV here in Northern Virginia. I wouldn't say I'm going to specialize in beachfront properties because there are no beaches here. I mean, I think there's a man-made beach somewhere near here, but it's not large enough to make it a specialty area for me. So I couldn't specialize in that. However, perhaps I do have a home on the beach and you know all the neighbors and you say, I'm just gonna specialize in that, regardless of where you live, that's fine. But know your local landscape if you're gonna promote yourself locally as a niche expert there. If I'm in suburban Northern Virginia, I can't say I specialize in co-ops because there are few in suburban Northern Virginia. I would have to go more into the city part for that. So you need to know what really exists in your local landscape. I have a bonus for you. This is just a bonus and we're about to wrap up because I want to look at Q&A. Specialize in lead generation strategies. You may not even want to specialize in the types that I shared with you, but you may say, well, all of my leads will come from cold calling. All of my leads will come from door knocking. I don't know if people still door knock or not. All my leads will come from the PTA at my son's school. Whatever you want your niche to be, you can do it by way of how you generate the leads. It may not even be necessarily that you're promoting luxury or you're promoting move up or you're promoting first-time home buyers. It's just I serve anyone that comes from the school or what have you. So that's another way to look at the niche markets. Another bonus is prioritize what's important to you. Brian Buffini says, when your priorities are clear, your decisions are easy. That resonates with me because your priorities will help define your niche area. If it's something, if I say, well, I'm going to sell castles in the French Riviera, but it's priority for me to be here maybe with my family, I may not can do that right now. Maybe that's a move up goal. It's a move up niche. Maybe it's a great aspiration, but it may not fit here today. So you have to look at your situation and know what your priorities are. So if I am tempted to sell castles and go show castles in the French Riviera, which would be wonderful actually when I think about it, if I'm even tempted, I can know if it fits into my whole plan. So know your priorities. Required reading, if you're going to specialize, is the Blue Ocean Strategy book. This book has nothing to do with real estate, but everything to do with real estate. It talks about how to create uncontested market space and make the competition absolutely irrelevant. And it talks about those industries and those businesses such as the Cirque du Soleil that went a little different from Barnum and Bailey. They were in the circus business, but they said, we're not going to do it the same way. So it starts with the Cirque du Soleil. It talks about Tesla, what Tesla did to the car industry. So those are just some of the examples, but it takes you through a number of different businesses that took a blue ocean strategy approach. And that is what a niche will do. It'll put you in a blue ocean to the point that, you know, we started off this session talking about the competition. It will put you in a different area where competition is not even there. It just doesn't exist. This is required reading. Get this book. Homework for you. Perform an inventory of your values. What are they? What do you really care about? What is your core? Ask yourself, what makes you different in the marketplace? What makes you stand out? Lastly, what niche type would you still serve if money were not an issue? Answer that question, because that may be what you're supposed to be doing. Okay. Very good, you all. Thank you so much. I'm going to look at the Q&A real quick. So I'm going to look at the Q&A and see if there are any questions or comments. But this is how you can take a picture of the screen if you want to connect with me more, if you want to talk more about niche marketing and ideas. Definitely reach out to me. I look forward to collaborating with you. I appreciate your patience, first of all, with all the technology. So let me stop sharing real quick and go to the Q&A. Okay. Am I still sharing? Okay. I'm not sharing. Let me see if there's any Q&A. Someone says, can you put up the different? Yes, I will put up the different properties at the very end when we close out. I'll just put it up there for a second. Okay. So thank, yes, Patricia, I will do that. Yes. Someone else asked the same question. Let me look if there are any other comments. Reggie Copeland says ethics. Yes, Reggie definitely is a code of ethics extraordinaire and expert. Subject matter expert. Can you show the property type? Okay, everyone wants to see the property type. So let me put those up again. Thank you so much. I will do that. Okay. Let me put those up. Okay, so I'm gonna give you like 10 seconds to take a picture of them. Where are they? Here they are. Okay, so this is the first one in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You should have taken a picture of it by now. Next one in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, and last type of people in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, very good. Hopefully those were the only questions we had. So let me make sure. Thank you all. Thank you. Okay, so this concludes our session. Thank you all so much for attending and for bearing with our technology issues. I'm just so indebted to your patience, and I look forward to collaborating with you. Thank you so much, and you all have a wonderful day and enjoy the conference. I'm reading the comments if you wonder. Yep, so we're good with that.
Combo training. Press the arrow on the top right to close the session. Okay. I couldn't hear you. Thank you.